This screencast demonstrates how to use steam tables. And steam tables list certain properties of steam. And the ones in particular that we're interested in are specific enthalpy, specific internal energy, and specific volume. They can also list specific entropy, but in this screencast, we'll focus on the three I mentioned. So what do we mean by specific? This means per unit mass or unit moles. And in the steam tables that we're going to look at, it'll be per mass. In particular, the enthalpy and the internal energy will be in kilojoules per kilogram, and the specific volume will be in meters cubed per kilogram. So there are three parts of the steam tables that are usually used. The first ones have to do with saturated steam. And what that means is that you have steam and water in equilibrium. So once you have a pressure, or you know the pressure, the temperature is automatically fixed. Vice versa, if you know the temperature, the pressure is automatically fixed. The third one that we're going to look at is superheated steam. And superheated steam, you're going to need both the pressure and the temperature to find your properties, because you are beyond the vapor-liquid equilibrium line. So let's start with saturated steam. We can look at two different tables, but let's look at the first one, which lists the properties by pressure. Note we have in this column the different pressures in bar. In this column, we have temperatures that correspond to these pressures. Again, because this is saturated, once you have the pressure, you know the temperature. So let's see how we use this. We're told that we have saturated steam at 30 bar, and we are looking for the specific enthalpy. So we go to our table and we find 30 bar. So at 30 bar, you see that the temperature is 233.85 degrees Celsius, and we have our specific volume of both the water and the steam. We have our specific internal energy, and now we have our specific enthalpy. So we're asked for the steam, so our specific enthalpy is therefore 2,803.2 kilojoules per kilogram. If we had wanted instead the enthalpy of the saturated water, then we'd look at this one right here. So let's try another one. Let's say we want the saturated water, and it's at 45 bar, and we are looking for the specific volume. So let's go to our chart again. So here we are at 45 bar, and here would be all the properties that we would need for saturated water or steam at 45 bar. Here we want saturated water and we want the specific volume. So we would look at this value right here, 0.0012696 meters cubed per kilogram. So that's the first way that you can use a steam table. Again, for saturated steam, now we're going to look for our properties under temperature. So let's use this to find another value. Let's say that we have a pressure that's equal to 60 bar and our temperature is equal to 500 degrees C. Now we're looking at this particular part of the table. And the properties we therefore have are the specific enthalpy, which is 3,423.1 kilojoules per kilogram. The specific internal energy, which is 3,083.1 kilojoules per kilogram. And finally, our specific volume, which is 0.056671 meters cubed per kilogram. Again, note that you need both the pressure and the temperature to find superheated steam properties. So once you're comfortable with steam tables, you can use their properties to solve mass and energy balances that use steam.